Hey, you know what? Samsung's made some pretty good Android devices in the past 12 months. They've made them in all different shapes, sizes, configurations, and they're available on all different carriers in the United States. What's going on, guys? I'm Aaron from PhoneDog.com, and I've got two very special ones, minus the voice crack, two very special ones in my hands right now. The Samsung Galaxy Note, the unlocked version, and the Samsung Galaxy Nexus on Verizon. Both of these are Samsung devices, and they both got some pretty unique specs. This is coming to AT&T soon, but this is the international version with a 1.4 gigahertz dual core processor, a massive 5.3 inch display, and an 8 megapixel camera with Android 2.3. This is like a phone and a tablet combined. Then you have the Samsung Galaxy Nexus over here. It's got a 1.2 gigahertz dual core TI-OMAP processor, and it's the first device to run Ice Cream Sandwich Android 4.0 along with a 5 megapixel camera and a nice 4.65 inch display. Which one of these should you go with? We're gonna find out in the dogfight right now, but first some love to Best Buy Mobile, since they hook us up with phones like this for use in our One Paw Bandit game. When you go into Best Buy Mobile, you'll walk out working. They'll help you set up your email, your web, your calls, your camera settings, and more on these devices, so when you walk out, you're good to go. Let's take a look at it. It's dogfight time. Galaxy Note, Galaxy Nexus. Let's have a look, starting right now. Two awesome Samsung devices, one of which is coming to AT&T soon. This is the Samsung Galaxy Note, and this is the international version we're using on camera right now. And the specs are a little bit different than the version that's coming to AT&T. This packs a 1.4 gigahertz dual core Exynos processor. In the AT&T version, it's going to be a 1.5 gigahertz dual core Snapdragon processor, so keep that in mind. But same 5.3 inch Super AMOLED HD display, 800 by 1280, 8 megapixel camera on the back with 1080p HD video recording, and Android 2.3 with TouchWiz version 4.0. Now, this is supposed to get Ice Cream Sandwich in the first quarter. Interestingly enough, Samsung didn't clarify whether that was going to be the unlocked version or the unlocked version and AT&T's version, but it will be packing 4G LTE connectivity. But for the purpose of this dogfight, we're going to be reviewing the, doing a head-to-head with the international version. 2,500 milliamp hour battery in the back as well, and this thing is huge. Take a look at this as opposed to, let's say, for example, even the Galaxy Nexus, you could see with a 4.65 inch display, or the HTC Sensation XL with a 4.7 inch display, or even the iPhone 4S with a case on it with a 3.5 inch display. You can really tell the differences here. It's a big device, it's a phone, it's a tablet, it's a hybrid device between the two. And then you have the Galaxy Nexus over here on the right side. This is available now at Verizon for $299.99, and it's the first device in the United States to run Ice Cream Sandwich and be available on retail shelves. So Android 4.0 on this device, and it's a stock build of Android 4.0. So you'll notice immediately the differences here between TouchWiz 4.0 running atop Android 2.3, and then of course Ice Cream Sandwich version 4.0 in its stock form over here. And you can see apps and widgets are grouped together, and it's a little bit different. Other specs: 1.2 gigahertz dual core TI-OMAP processor. It's got a 5 megapixel camera on the back with 1080p HD video recording. It's got a 4.65 inch Super AMOLED display. And then it has a 1,850 milliamp hour battery as well. This is an HD display, a Super AMOLED HD 720p display. So this is a 720p. So both HD displays. So interestingly enough, it'll be kind of wild to compare those two, because this does use Pentile technology, which a lot of people, if you've done your research, a lot of people hate Pentile and a lot of people love it. So it's interestingly enough, a battle between two HD devices, a battle between two Samsung devices, so a lot of similarities here across the board. But let's dive right into this, and you can really, again, see the size difference between the two. Take a look at how this looks in hand. I mean, I can't, from the bottom of this device, I can't reach all the way up to the top. And actually, it's so big, I probably need to zoom out just a little bit. And so we can get a better picture of the Galaxy Note here. So you can see Android 2.3 atop, TouchWiz version 4.0, and out of the box, because it's an unlocked device, you don't get a whole lot, or actually any carrier installed bloatware. You get S-Memo, which is something we'll cover in just a little bit. Basically, this device comes with a stylus, a capacitive stylus down here at the bottom that allows you to do text and take notes in meetings or class or things like that. But just to do a recap while it's on my mind, volume rocker on the left side, power button on the right side, micro USB charging port down there on the bottom with the S pin, which is what they call it. And on the international version, you have two capacitive buttons here and a physical home button, a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, and of course your camera on the back. But S Memo pre-installed. You do get some Samsung stuff like Social Hub, Music Hub, Reader's Hub, Keys Air. You get an All Share, Photo Editor, And then thanks to Samsung for pointing that out, it's Kyzair, not Kyzair. Crayon Physics, S-Choice, so basically a lot of apps that center around your ability to use the S Pen. Then you have Samsung apps pre-installed as well, along with some applications that I've pre-installed out of the box. So not a whole lot of bloat on this device, and quite a bit of it is if you do get any sort of, you know, user stuff that you've installed yourself, you can uninstall that without having to worry too much. Then you've got the Galaxy Nexus over here. This is mostly a stock build of Ice Cream Sandwich. The only exception to the rule here is it comes with two Verizon pre-installed applications, My Verizon Mobile and Visual Voicemail. And actually, I want to say, take that back, Visual Voicemail is the one that can be uninstalled. There's one other one that can't. VZ Backup Assistant, that's what it is. My Verizon Mobile and VZ Backup Assistant. So to be touted as a stock Ice Cream Sandwich device, you know, that Nexus name is symbolic for a stock Android experience. People were kind of up in arms about the fact that, you know, that they had some Verizon stuff pre-installed on it. So, you know, it is interesting to see the reaction there. But, you know, obviously I don't really see that stuff as a huge issue. It is two small applications. And otherwise, you get a pretty stock experience here. You get 5 home screens over on the Galaxy Nexus, whereas you get 7 home screens over here. And you can do your nifty little TouchWiz features. Pinch to zoom out, and you can select different screens. And you can see how fast the performance is. Also, I want to point out to you here the notifications bar. You can see you've got some toggles up here at the top, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, GPS, silent mode, and auto rotation, along with the notifications area. Here's how it looks in Ice Cream Sandwich. So you can see the difference here, the date, and then of course the network ID down here at the bottom, and you do get a nice shortcut to settings. What I really like though is when you come out and you come back from the lock screens, and you can see the different lock screens and how they look on these devices, you can still access the notifications bar on this on Ice Cream Sandwich without having to unlock the screen. You can't do that over here on this device. You have to unlock it fully before you access that. So a little bit of a difference there, and of course you have quick access to the camera, quick access to unlock the screen. And that's a pretty decent little touch there. Otherwise, 5 home screens, and again, widgets and apps are kind of all combined here, and I can easily switch back and forth between apps and widgets. Now, I get a lot of stock Android widgets here, like analog clock, bookmarks, calendar, and more. But I do see some nice widgets that are customizable as well. Let's take a look at the email widget here, for example, and you can see when I press and hold it, I can customize it and really change the size around. So you do get customizable widgets over here on Ice Cream Sandwich, at least with some of the widgets that come out of the box. So it's nice to see stock Android modified and allowing things like that. And then over on TouchWiz size, you do get that as well. We'll bring up some widgets, for example, and you can see the difference here between pressing and holding, and it brings up directly to wallpapers on Ice Cream Sandwich. You have to access widgets by going to the actual menu, whereas here, you can access all your different widgets by pressing and holding the screen. So we'll bring up AccuWeather, for example, and you can see that like the others, let me back out of that real quick. It's customizable as well as soon as it decides to come back. There we go. So let's press and hold on this. And then we'll change it up a little bit so you can see I can change the size of this, modify it around. So it's really nice when I have an area that's particularly tight on space. I can kind of control the way that it looks, and it's a good touch. Also, another thing I want to point out is Ice Cream Sandwich's change over to on-screen buttons. You'll notice these 3 on-screen buttons down here at the bottom, back, home, and then running applications, whereas down here you've got all your buttons on screen. It's a little bit different, and you'll see that when I turn the screen off, those buttons go away as well and leaves only the earpiece. Then of course when it's lit, a notification light that's down here at the bottom of the device in my front-facing camera. The buttons come back though when I come back to the home screen, and of course they go away when I'm watching video content to really take advantage of that full 4.65 inch HD display. Now over here, you've obviously got physical buttons. This is something that's new with Ice Cream Sandwich. All Ice Cream Sandwich devices going forward are supposed to have on-screen buttons. So physical buttons are going the way of the dinosaur. You won't see those on future devices. Now you wouldn't know that based on CES because a lot of these devices are still launching with Android 2.3, but this is the wave of the future along with your menu button down here in the middle and your shortcuts over on the side. So just a little bit of a difference in the way that it looks and the way that things scroll, and just, you know, little aesthetic things that are different. Let's take a look at PhoneDog.com. Now this again is not the LTE version. This is the HSPA Plus International version, whereas this is Verizon's 4G LTE version. So we're going to load up PhoneDog, and I'm going to pull this away so I can actually see it. Let's see, PhoneDog.com. Let's go over to PhoneDog, and we'll load that up. And then of course I can come over here, pull it away so I can see it. PhoneDog.com. So you can see, because the display is so huge over here, 5.3 inches as opposed to 4.65, you can really see that it's optimized for kind of a desktop-like experience. You've got back and forth buttons, your URL area, your open windows, your bookmarks, and then of course typical browser settings that you've seen on past Samsung devices. down here at the bottom. So I can load up, it's loading PhoneDog right now, and we'll see. You can see that there's a little bit, I wouldn't say it was a stutter, but a little bit of an animation lag, if you will, between those two. And PhoneDog's loading right now, and you can really see how responsive pitch to zoom is on this bad boy. And this is where this 5.3-inch display really comes in handy, and transition effects are nice and fast. So overall, a very zippy device, and I do, like the rest of the Galaxy S2 series, have that ability to press and hold on the screen and tilt in and out to really make this device my own and zoom in without using my two fingers to pinch to zoom. I can put down my thumbs and move, and it's kind of a real-time zoom as opposed to a typical kind of forced pinch to zoom. But this is nice and it's fast. You can see very responsive with little to no lag, and again, the transition effects look good. Now over here, 4G connectivity on Verizon Wireless, and you can see very fast over here as well. TI OMAP processors are kind of known for their web browsing capabilities, at least the way that they render web pages, and I've been relatively pleased with the pinch to zoom performance of this one as well. So you can see, and I'm loading up that Dell ad that's at the bottom of our site. Hang on one second. Let's go back to phonedog.com and we'll load that back up again. So you can see pinch to zoom responsiveness, very good. And because Ice Cream Sandwich is a new build, you can see the browser area. And we'll scroll back up so you can take a look. The URL area, my bookmark, or my open windows rather. I can scroll back and forth between those quick and easily. And I have the ability to add more. I can bookmark, or I can go into individual settings, which is a nice touch.